Depending on your business strategy, the concept of user retention might be all important. Many businesses will lose money to gain a user, but then hope to make it up over time. And we often talk about cohort analysis and retention, and it can be particularly interesting if you have large events that drive people in batches. I tend to think of cohorts kind of like a generation. You have your millennials, your boomers, Gen X, etc., or even a graduating class. You all entered your freshman year at one time, you move up, and then you all leave at the same time, and it can be an interesting way to measure things. In a business context, seasonality is a common cohort creator. You might think of an airline. They might have very different behavior and lifetime value associated with a cohort of heavy business travel time versus a cohort who bought tickets for the holiday time frame. I would guess that business travelers are going to be more frequent repeat visitors and probably stick to weekday flights, while Christmas visitors might not travel again until that time next year and probably prefer weekends. Now, if this analysis turns out to be correct, you could plan campaigns and promotions and content around that, as well as the segments. So we also see, if you scroll down here, we've got user retention and lifetime value. And although I mentioned above we have more returning users in total, this is a pretty long tail here in terms of many people who do not return for a second visit. And that tells me that the ones who do return tend to keep returning. So you either love this game or you never played a second time, I guess. For this cohort reporting, I actually want to skip over here to one of their pre-built reports. So I'm going to go down here to Analysis, the Template Gallery, and they've got an entire one here on cohort analysis that lets us dive in a little bit deeper. So here we can see the week that people started, so 4 weeks ago, and then we can see each week after that how many of them remained. So 4 weeks ago, we would have 4 weeks of data, and 1 week ago, we'd have 1 week of data, hence the waterfall here. We can change just about everything. We can change the segments, which is always useful. We can change the return criteria, the granularity here from weekly to daily or monthly, and even what value we're looking to measure. So we're looking right now at active users, but we could look at something like user engagement instead. So for example, we would come over here and scroll through here, find user engagement, apply that one, and it now becomes an option, and I can change my metric from active users to user engagement. The other thing I might want to look at, this is a total sum. You may want to look at this in terms of per user, and we can see what happens on a per user basis as time goes on. We see a big drop right away, and then things even out a bit. One thing that might be interesting to look at would be ad revenue or in-app purchases as well. And perhaps you lose users, but as the levels get harder, the people who are still there might choose to buy the power-ups to keep advancing in the game. Who knows? There's all kinds of interesting analysis, and it's all here for the slicing and dicing.